Okay, this is a redo of the positive-negative example to take into account the case. What if we want 0 to be neutral instead of positive? And so all we do is we add another if statement here. If number is equivalent to, don't forget, double equal to compare. So number, if number equals 0, if that's true, we're going to just say that 0 is neutral. Else, now we have a nested if. And so here we have an if within the else statement. So if number is greater than 0, don't forget to change this, since we're equal is going to be 0. So if it's greater than 0, it's going to be positive, else it's going to be negative. Okay. Although not necessary in this case, we could add the braces like this to help keep track of the nested if. So notice for this if else, which is one unit, we have the if part is contained within braces. The else part, including all the nested if else here, is contained with this open brace and this closed brace. So if this is true, this happens. If it's true, you skip the else, so you would skip over this whole thing. So none of this would be evaluated. So that can be an advantage with nested ifs. It can be more efficient. So you only evaluate what you need to in certain cases. So the braces will help you keep track. So it also helps you know if you missed anything, because for this if else, notice all the braces line up, and there's a couple of different ways you can do this, conventions. But either of the conventions are gonna have, will help you keep things straight, because all this will be lined up. So this if else has its own open and close. Remember, it's not necessary in this case because each statement has only one statement following the condition. So if it's 0, this and only this happens. Braces become necessary if you have more than one statement following the if or following the else. And we'll probably see that in future examples.